الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. A brother sent me a clip of Mohammed Hijab who's asked about using philosophy in da'wah. What is the purpose?
So how are you guys doing? Some people ask the question, for what purposes do you use philosophy in da'wah? The answer is for two main purposes. Number one, an instrumental purpose. And this instrumental purpose is to bring people to the religion of Islam. That is because it will be circular reason to try and prove the Quran with the Quran. So you need to have a vantage point outside of the Quran in order to prove it. Now, for example, proving God's existence or the prophethood of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The second thing is to deconstruct. Second purpose, to deconstruct false ideologies.
There's another part of this answer, which himself refuted himself, you know. But let us go in details. Firstly, clearly from the answer of Mohammed Hijab, we can see clearly Mohammed Hijab, may Allah guide us and guide him, he's been heavily influenced, he's upon the wave Ahl Kalam, who were heavily influenced by Greek philosophy, which the Salaf want and guessed, the likes of Abu Hanifa, Shafi, Ahmed ibn Hanbal, Bukhari, and other than them, Ibn Mubarak, and may Allah have mercy upon them all. That's clearly, you can see that, and this is what Fakhruddin al-Razi said and other people al-Kalam, they said we cannot use the Quran and the Sunnah to prove the Quran and the Sunnah, we have to use something outside it, otherwise we'll be circular reasoning. So firstly, let's go in details. The first point, he said,
and this instrumental purpose is to bring people to the religion of Islam.
So we say to Muhammad Hijab, the answer to this statement of yours, that Allah said in the Quran, قُلْ هَذِهِ سَبِيلِي أَدْعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ عَلَىٰ بَصِيرَةٍ أَنَا وَمَنِ اتَّبَعَنِي وَسُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَنَا مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ. The meaning of the verse, say, this is my path, O Muhammad, say, this is my path. I call to Allah, okay, upon basira, to Allah, to Islam, okay, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the teaching of Islam, and I and those who follow me. And I'm not from the polytheists. Glory be to Allah, I'm not from the polytheists. So when Prophet Muhammad said, when he was conveyed the message that he called upon Basira, that Basira Muhammad Hijab, that Prophet called with, cannot be philosophy. Why? Because you mentioned clearly, explicitly, you're going to use something outside the Quran.
So you need to have a vantage point outside of the Quran in order to prove it.
And we know Prophet Muhammad SAW was conveying to the non-Muslims. Brothers and sisters, pay attention. Prophet Muhammad SAW was not giving da'wah to Muslims. He was calling to non-Muslims to Islam. Yes, he was teaching the Muslims here, of course, teaching the Muslims. But his da'wah to the non-Muslims. He came, people didn't believe in Allah. They believed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or they worship something beside him. They mushrikun, some they were dahriyun. You know, they believe just in what they call it, nothing will destroy them except nature. There's no day of resurrection. They reject Prophet Muhammad SAW and prophethood. So he, Prophet Muhammad SAW, was what? Qul, always the Arab pagans will try to use something and guess him. Allah will reveal the revelation to respond to them. So Prophet Muhammad SAW, so now I the Muhammad Hijab, you are following Prophet Muhammad SAW, and no way you are from Prophet SAW, because clearly you said you're going to utilize philosophy which is outside the Quran and the Sunnah, and the Prophet Muhammad SAW was utilizing the revelation to call to his Lord alayhi salatu wassalam. Okay, or you're gonna say I'm not following Prophet Muhammad SAW, and that is clear, you're not following Prophet Muhammad SAW. That is clear. It's from your statement, ilzam, no doubt about that. Because you have, with your own mouth, said you're going to utilize something outside the Quran to call on non-Muslims, you know, to prove his prophethood. Prophet Muhammad SAW did not do that. He used the revelation that was revealed to him to prove his prophethood. And we'll speak about this issue in details. Second one.
That is because it will be circular reasoning to try and prove the Quran with the Quran. So you need to have a vantage point outside of the Quran in order to prove it.
Clearly, Muhammad Hijab, just as his spiritual forefathers, Al-Kalam, mixed up between two matters, two issues. And it's very important to separate them. Firstly, yes, we do agree, no doubt about that. You cannot say to people, believe Islam is the truth because Allah said Islam is the truth, full stop. That's called circular reasoning. Or you say Prophet Muhammad is a true prophet because Prophet Muhammad said is a prophet, full stop. That's called circular reasoning. Okay, however, Muhammad Hijab, may Allah guide you to the truth. The Quran does not just say the Quran is speech of Allah and full stop. No, Allah gives the best and the strongest and the most powerful, rational, intellectual, logical, tangible proofs. When I say logical, by the way, I'm not talking about Greek logic. If you believe the only time to use logic you have to be a philosopher, then you have this dunya that you are mutakhabbat. Logic, there's something called logic which human have it. You know, whole the whole is bigger than half. It's ma'roof. It's a logical thing. You know, child knows that if you give him two biscuits and you give the other child one, he knows that what you did is injustice to him. He knows two is bigger than one. He didn't study, it's logical to him. He didn't study Greek logic. So let's go back. Logical means a fitri, something is fitri. And the nas, daruriyat, not daruriyat. That which is not by necessity. You know, Allah uses that to prove the Quran speech of Allah. To prove Allah is a true ilah and is a creator and he's the one who create everything and he deserves to be worshipped alone. To prove that their resurrection that will be will occur without any doubt. To prove the prophethood of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So why Muhammad wants to go outside? Because Muhammad even tried to hide, pretending to be defender of Islam and the Muslims, and he's a savior of the Muslim nation, and he's going to save Muslims from leaving Islam and so on. He has this inferiority complex toward the Greek philosophers or the Western philosophers and so on. And the fact that you can see how he praised them and looked up to them, and he tried to belittle the scholars of Sunnah, okay? And may Allah guide him, and may Allah protect us from that. So when you say it's a circular reasoning, then, because according to you, circular reasoning is batil, it's false, no doubt about that. Circular is reasoning, because you need to make distinction. Alhamdulillah, we, Al-Sunnah al-Jama'ah, by Allah's tawfiq, we made that distinction, because he did not make that distinction. So when you say circular reasoning, so are you saying Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used the false premises to prove his prophethood? Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used the Quran. Allah used the Quran. So Allah used something outside the Quran? Prophet used something outside the Quran? He used the Quran, he used the revelation. So either Prophet was doing, he used a false premises, or you are who corrupted with this kalam, with this evil statement, satanic statement. Make a tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from this evil statement, kufri statement. That Prophet, according to his statement, because he said it's a circular reasoning, we know Prophet Muhammad used the Quran. The proof for that, clear in the verse in Surah Al-Furqan. Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا يَأْتُونَكَ بِمَثَلٍ إِلَّا جِئْنَاكَ بِالْحَقِّ وَأَحْسَنَ تَفْسِيرًا. Surah Al-Furqan, verse number 33. طيب. He said here, Shaykh Ibn Taymiyyah, أخبر أن الكفار لا يأتون بقياس عقلي لباطلهم إلا جاءه الله بالحق وجاءه من البيان والدليل وضرب المثل بما هو أحسن تفسيرا وكشفا وإضاح الحق من قياسهم. الله أكبر الله أكبر. So when Allah سبحانه وتعالى, and this verse clearly exposed Muhammad Hijab in a way that he has to make tawbah from the evil statement. When Allah سبحانه وتعالى said the meaning of the verse, they will not come, because why? The Arab pagans, the kuffar, from the Christians even, the Yahud, the Mushrikun, they will try to encounter the argument of the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whatever argument, the meaning of it, intellectual, so-called intellectual argument or analogy, they will bring against you, except, listen Muhammad Hijab, listen my brothers and sisters who are following this individual, may Allah guide him. Listen to this. Either you are following the book of Allah, Muhammad Hijab is not following the book of Allah, may Allah guide him in this giving da'wah. Let me be specific, in giving da'wah. Okay, he mentioned that clearly, he said he has to go outside, you know? So what Allah said, I did not say, except we tell you to go back to the Greek logic and philosophy and use and guess them. No. إِلَّا جِئْنَاكَ بِالْحَقِّ وَأَحْسَنَ تَفْسِيرًا. Except we reveal to you the truth and the best of explanation. The logical, rational, my brothers and sisters, remember this for me, and inshallah this might be my statement until I meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best and the greatest and the most powerful, intellectual, rational, logical, tangible proofs, proving Allah's existence, proving Allah deserves to be worshipped alone, proving Yawm al-Qiyamah, proving the usul and of the deen, except is in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there is nothing outside it better than it. Remember this. This is my statement, inshallah, until I meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah save us from deviations. So, Allah did not say, go to philosophy. We give you, O Muhammad, Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, O Muhammad Hijab, read the Quran, akhi, may Allah bless you, read. May Allah guide you to the truth, read the Quran. I'm not trying to be sarcastic here, but read the Quran, even myself. Let us read the Quran. Let us stay away sometimes from the videos and stay away from the speaker's corner and read the Quran to know the best example, the best way to call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in the Quran. The greatest intellectual proof is in the Quran and the Sunnah of Nabi alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي أقوى من محمد حجاب and those who have been influenced by the garbage and the rubbish of Greek logic and philosophy. إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي أقوى. This Quran guides to that which is best. Best in proving Allah's existence. Best in proving that Allah should be worshipped alone. Best in refuting the doubts of people of innovation and misguidance and of people of disbelief. However, you need to go back to the scholars of tafsir and you see the deriving the ma'ani, because the Quran is eloquent. You know, one word, two words, but has a lot of meaning, a lot of ways, a lot of examples, a lot of argument that can be utilized from the Quran and the Sunnah. Barakallahu feekum. The best in ibadah, the best in sharia, the best in everything. The Quran guide us to that which is the best in this life and the hereafter. Muhammad Hijab, may Allah guide you to the truth. Barakallahu feekum. So, Allah mentioned another verse, Muhammad Hijab, and those who have been affected by you, may Allah guide you to the truth. وَلَقَدْ صَرَّفْنَا فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لِلنَّاسِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ أَكْثَرَ شَيْءٍ جَدَلًا Surat al-Kahf. And we have given in this Quran to people مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ like examples, Allah explained everything, every argument that the Arab pagans or the people of misguidance try to use against Islam, except Allah refuted it and debunked it and established that Islam is the truth and whatever go against it is falsehood. However, you have to reflect, that's what Allah said, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. We have to reflect upon the Quran. For example, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ. This, what is the meaning of it? That's you break it down, you know, as the ulama did. When I did that, by the way, side point, when I did that, one of the follower of Muhammad Hijab, he said, Shamsi is using philosophy. Guess, I'm using the Quran, you know. I'm using tafsir of the Quran, of the ayah. He said, I'm using philosophy. Why? As Ibn Qayyim said, some Muslims been suffering with this inferiority complex. They think there is no intellectual proof in the Quran. So if you're going to rationalize something, therefore you are a philosopher. Bro, People use the intellect before Greek philosophy came into existence, before the Indian philosophy, before the Egyptian philosophy. What are you talking about? Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Sahaba never used the aql until this al-mutalakhbit al-khabith Aristotle come. Na'udhu billah min dhalik. So I hope that is clear. Also mentioned another point. He said with that it would be circular reasoning, okay? As I've mentioned, there's difference between the two, okay? So the Quran, alhamdulillah, is full of logical arguments, rational arguments. And Muhammad Hijab, you cannot say, when I said, let us use the philosophy, I meant intellectual, rational argument, because that will lead you to claim, that will necessitate that your rational, logical argument, which is outside the Quran, is better than the logical, rational argument, which is in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned. And that is a kufri statement. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. So what are you going to choose now? Except to make a tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and turn back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and study, and go benefit from Sheikh Abu Iyad and from the scholars before that. May Allah guide us and guide you to the truth. So you have no escape except to make a tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because this statement is evil. It's evil. You know? Also, he mentioned that. And so I'm not, listen, brothers and sisters, don't say Shamsi is putting words in his mouth. No. Muhammad Hijab goes on to say,
second purpose, to deconstruct false ideologies.
But I thought we use the Quran and the Sunnah as a criteria. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, O Muhammad Hijab, and my brothers and sisters in Islam, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. إيش هو؟ هدى للناس. هدى العرب للناس. وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. You know? بينات. And also بينات. You know, a circular reasoning doesn't apply to بينات. And Quran is بين. بينات. Full of بينات. Quran بينات is self-evident. For example, if I say there is a sun, you cannot tell me, prove to me sun exists during the day when the sun is clear. when the sky is clear and you see the sun, okay? You know, or for example, something which is self-evident. I'm خُلِقُ مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ مِنْ خَالِقُونَ. Were they created by nothing, or did they create themselves, or did they create the heavens and the earth? This is a clear proof. Don't say no. Prove that is proof, or prove to me that it's true. Or I hope that is clear. Quran is bayin, self-evident, does not need a proof, because it's proof by itself. And the Quran is full of it, alhamdulillah. As I've mentioned, the rational, logical, tangible argument is in the Quran, proving the lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his worship, his names, attributes, his his prophet, the prophethood is of Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam. So the Quran is al Furqan, Muhammad. We use the Quran and Sunnah as a criteria over everything. Because if you are using philosophy as a criteria, as a starting point, so therefore philosophy has an upper hand over the Quran and the Sunnah. A'udhu billah min dhalik. A'udhu billah min dhalik. And I never heard anyone saying we use philosophy as a criteria, or to use philosophy to deconstruct. We use the Quran and Sunnah. Quran and Sunnah has an upper hand. Quran and Sunnah is a criteria over the philosophy, any philosophy, Greek philosophy, Indian philosophy, Chinese philosophy, Egyptian philosophy, Babylonian philosophy, Arab philosophy, any philosophy. The Quran and Sunnah is the criteria. Whatever goes in the Quran and Sunnah, say yes, Quran and Sunnah is better than it, as Ibn Qayyim said. Even now, some statement they say, the philosophers before, which has true in it, but the Quran and Sunnah is better than it. You know? Better than it, all these philosophers, they were taken from the Quran and the Sunnah. But Mohammed Hijab cannot say that. Cannot say, I've been taken from the Quran and Sunnah, because clearly he said he's going to use something outside the Quran, not something being derived from the Quran and the Sunnah. Okay, because Shamsi Uthaymeen, may Allah have mercy upon him, said yes, if you go to a non-Muslim, you cannot tell him Allah said, because maybe he hates Islam, he's going to shut down. So what you do, you use the argument of the Quran without saying Allah said. Like for example, were you created by nothing? Nothing is not even a thing, let alone to create something else. Or to create your own self. So what you're doing, you are utilizing the Quran and Sunnah. But without telling Quran and Sunnah, and you can watch my video when I spoke to those Danish young people, while I guide them, I mentioned that at the end. I said, well, I've used it from the, taken from the Quran and the Sunnah. But Muhammad Hijab, so I advise you to read the book of Sheikh Abdul Rahman bin Nasir al-Sa'di. I'll give you one verse, Muhammad Hijab, because I believe, while I guide you, there's a verse in the Quran, one verse, just one verse, prove the Quran is the word of Allah. And this verse is intellectual, logical, tangible proofs to prove the Quran is the word of Allah and the Prophet Muhammad is the true prophet. In Surah Al-Baqarah, وَإِنْ كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِسُورَةٍ مِنْ مِثْلِهِ وَادْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا وَلَنْ تَفْعَلُوا فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ الَّتِي وَقُودُهَا النَّاسُ وَالْحِجَارَةُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْكَافِرِينَ. This verse, Sheikh Abdul Nasir al-Sa'di, I will advise my brothers and sisters to go back and check it. This verse is clear, rational, logical proof, tangible, that Prophet Muhammad is a true prophet. And I will advise my brothers and sisters, even Mohammed Hijab, go watch my video I did in Bristol, why Islam is the truth. Yes, what we say, Islam goes in line with our universal tools. And those universal tools, don't say, those universal tools, I call philosophy. No, those universal tools, Allah create them in us. Sound reasoning. You don't have to go philosophy. This is sound reasoning. Every human being has it. Natural English, al-fitra. Our perceptions. And that's what the Quran use. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَى جُنُوبِهِمْ وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا سُبْحَانَكَ فَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. These are tangible proofs for Allah's existence, the creator, and is the one who deserves to be worshipped. هَذَا خَلْقُ اللَّهِ فَارُونِي مَاذَا خَلَقَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونِهِ. That is Allah's creation. So tell me, those who you have been worshipped besides Allah, what they have created. If they say, the cow creates something, say the cow is created, cannot create the heavens and the earth. It's a logical, tangible proofs. Allahu Akbar. Come back to Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. May Allah guide us and guide you to the truth. At the end of this clip, Muhammad Hijab, you know what he said?
Now, we don't use philosophy for the purposes of completing something which we believe is already complete, which is Islam, the Quran, the Sharia, and the perfect, pure way. This, and we won't compromise on our principles. with anyone who wants to compromise. They wish that they could compromise with you, they said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah mentioned the Quran so that you may compromise with them.
Brother, you just said you have to go outside. You need philosophy to contribute to Islam, which is outside the Quran and the Sunnah. It's not based upon the Quran and the Sunnah. Then you say, we are not sure to complete something is incomplete. So either philosophy is in the Quran and the Sunnah, but you cannot say that because clearly you say it's outside the Quran and the Sunnah. Because if you use it as in the Quran, according to you, is a circular reasoning. So you have nowhere to escape. Mohammed Hijab, may Allah guide you to the truth. Stay away from videos and go study. May Allah bless you and all of us. Allah al-musta'an. Why I'm getting frustrated. If you see how many people like the video. 2,000 people like the video. That's when you know we are in a mess. May Allah protect us. But alhamdulillah, still khair in the Muslim ummah. Walhamdulillah. So this is the response to Mohammed Hijab. Inshallah ta'ala, I will make another video showing the aqwal of Ahl al-Ilm from the other firaq, from the Asha'ir and other than them. Warning and guess, philosophy. Philosophy, we are not in need of it. If you are saying philosophy, use our aql, people use the aql before this philosophy, you know. And as I mentioned, there is no escape for you, Mohammed Hijab, because as I have demonstrated, we finish. May Allah guide you to the truth. And us, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us sincerity and to make us from those who follow Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam inwardly and outwardly. And my brothers and sisters, we have to study and learn, and we are not in need of Greek logic or Greek philosophy to prove Islam. Likewise, we are not in need of modern science to prove Islam. Islam prove itself by giving us logical, rational, tangible, intellectual proofs why Islam is the truth, why the Quran is the word of Allah, and why Prophet Muhammad is a true prophet, alayhi salatu wassalam, walhamdulillah.